are hippies, rebels against old-fashioned authority.
I think these kids need help.
They need it bad.
You're passing judgment on people you know nothing about. Maybe that's why your church is so empty.
When God walks in here, brings me a hippie, I'll ask him what it's all about. Because I do not understand.
This house has a very good vibe. Just in all the wrong places. If you want to reach my people, you need to speak to them in a language they understand.
If I bring them in, I'm going to lose my job.
We can only walk through doors open to us in your church. That's a door that's shut.
You probably noticed we have some guests here today. I'd like you to meet my new friends. Welcome.
Half of them aren't even wearing shoes.
They're staining the new shag carpet.
They need our help.
If you feel like you're misunderstood and judged,
you will find forgiveness and freedom right here.
That was awesome.
Now that door is open any time of day. And if there are some who don't like that, well then that door works both ways.
All right, Pastor, let's begin.
I was almost done with this. I think you did what nobody else would even dare.
That we found. I feel like I belong. You're gonna need a bigger church.
Our country is a dark and divided place, but now there's hope
and it's spreading.
This is your home, and I want you to tell all your friends about it.
Hello, and welcome to another Catholic Movie Monday here on Catholicism WoW. So today we're going to talk about the movie Jesus Revolution. First of all, this movie is about the founding of Calvary Chapel. So it's very steeped in Protestantism and Protestant theology. Any Catholic going into this movie is going to roll their eyes at a lot of the Protestant theology and the things that are said about both the Bible and the church, and even Christ himself in this movie. I know I did. But we're not here to talk about the theology of the movie. We're here to talk about the movie itself. Jesus Revolution is the true story of the founding of Calvary Chapel. It stars Kelsey Grammer. It stars Jonathan Roumie from The Chosen. Jonathan Roumie as Lonnie Frisbee turns in a fantastic performance. And it's weird, if you're only familiar with Jonathan from The Chosen, it's weird hearing him talk in his normal voice. I noticed this when he started doing ads for the Halo app. And I was just used to hearing him using that Hebrew almost Arabic sounding accent that he uses in The Chosen for Jesus. And it's just really weird because he just fits that role of Jesus so perfectly. He does that accent so perfectly that to hear him talk in his real voice is almost a shock. But he does use his real American accent in this movie, and he's fantastic. Kelsey Grammer obviously is fantastic. The movie chronicles when Pastor Chuck Smith, who was the founder of Calvary Chapel, met Lonnie Frisbee, and Calvary Chapel really began to grow from a small independent church into basically what it is now, which is pretty much its own Protestant denomination. Lonnie Frisbee was a hippie, and Chuck Smith was a very conservative Protestant pastor, and they were from separate worlds. They were from completely separate worlds, and when those worlds collided, they did good things for the church. Catholics can learn a lot from this movie about evangelism. That's one area where we really are sorely lacking. We don't go out and find, we don't go out and bring people into the church. It's almost like if you're interested in the Catholic Church, you need to seek us out. And we need to do better. We need to do better. And we can learn a lot about embracing other characters, other personality types. people that aren't like us. That's something that Chuck Smith has to learn in this movie. That's Kelsey Grammer's entire character arc, is learning how to open up his heart to people that he had dismissed outright just because they were weird and they were smelly and they didn't wear shoes and they didn't take baths. Jesus Revolution isn't a perfect movie. It's a good movie. It's a good movie. I recommend that everybody watch it, but it's by no means a perfect movie. It is it's 2 hours, but it feels more like 2.5. It tends to drag. A lot of it is really boring. They probably could have gotten in and out of this movie in 90 minutes and had it been a much tighter, much more entertaining film. I couldn't tell you off the top of my head, though, what I would cut out of it. A lot of it, I mean, it does tell a complete coherent story. It's just that some of that story drags and is really boring. So be prepared for that. If you're going to watch the movie, it does drag a bit. And it does feel a bit longer than it is. It was made by the same producers as I Can Only Imagine. I Can Only Imagine was a great movie. I'll be doing a review of that here at some point. And Jesus Revolution is on the same par with that. It really is. It's well produced. It's a much better movie than Christian, Protestant, you know, whatever you want to call it, movies generally are. This isn't God's Not Dead. This isn't, you know, the Kirk Cameron Left Behind movie. This is a good quality movie. Now, this movie did get a lot of criticism because the movie does not touch on the fact that Lonnie Frisbee was an unrepentant homosexual. At least as far as we know. And he did die of AIDS in the 1990s. So the idea of him being an unrepentant homosexual is probably pretty accurate. But this movie isn't about that. This movie isn't about Lonnie Frisbee. It's about Lonnie Frisbee's involvement in the Jesus movement of the late 60s and the early 70s. So it really wouldn't make sense for the movie to go into that part of Lonnie Frisbee's life. And it would do a disservice, I think, to the film to do that. But this movie has taken a lot of controversy because of that. People think that because Lonnie Frisbee was an unrepentant homosexual, that he wasn't a real Christian, and that you know, that he was a false teacher. I think he was a very confused young man. I think that's kind of evident in the movie as well. He is portrayed as a very confused young man, but a confused young man who's on fire for Jesus, whether it's for the right reasons or the wrong reasons. He does talk a lot about drug use and drug use in the hippie movement, and how the young people were looking for something, but they didn't know what, and they were looking for it in the wrong places. They were looking for it in the sexual revolution, or the, you know, psychedelic drugs, or, you know, whatever. And that he found what he was looking for in Christ. And I think that's a very powerful message that a lot of young people even today could hear. We do still have a massive drug problem. We do still have a massive hookup culture problem. We do still have a lot of those cultural norms that were started in the hippie movement are still very prevalent today. And it is still young people searching for meaning, searching for something, searching for something they could find in the church and in God. And we should be out there helping these young people to find this instead of hiding away in our parishes and our churches and making them come to us. I really think that evangelism is something that we as Catholics need to work on. And not just evangelism, but ecumenism. We need to be more welcoming. We need to be more understanding. We need to meet Protestants where they are, and that way we can bring them to where we are. So that's it. I really recommend everybody watch Jesus Revolution, even though it does tend to be a little bit boring in parts, mostly in the middle. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.